Hi, everyone. Welcome to Robyn's Roost. I'm Robyn Rasset, an independent Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. And today I want to share a fun card using the Slimline card style and using the Way to Goat stamp set. So let's just go ahead and get right at it. Here's the Way to Goat stamp set. It has three fun goat images and then five greetings, this cute little can image, you know, because we all know goats eat cans, right? And a little, like a background image to like put their feet in. We're not going to be using that today, but we will be using several of the other images. So here's the card, and you're going to start with a 8 by 9 inch piece of cardstock and then score it at 4 inches. And this is going to fit in a standard business envelope. So kind of the ones that you usually have laying around your house to mail bills, or at least we used to. Now we don't mail bills anymore, I guess. I still do because I'm old. So you're going to go ahead and start with your card base. Now I've cut two strips, of the Magic in This Night Designer Series paper. And this is jade green, our base. And we're just gonna layer these on. Hopefully I have them cut the right length. Okay, right here. Now, I like to use the liquid glue to put these on because they're a little bit narrow for tape runner. And I tend to get tape runner on the edges and then it gets all over my card and it's not a pretty sight. So you're just going to kind of keep these in, oh, I don't know, a quarter inch maybe from the outside edge and try to get them straight. Straight is not something I do real well. And I do have this one cut just a tad short, so I'm going to try to kind of split the difference. Okay. And we'll go ahead and get the other one on. So I like using little strips like this to use up those odd scraps of DSP that you end up with. And for this card, I was looking for something that went really well with jade green, and this Halloween Magic in This Night paper like went perfectly. Sure, and I have that one a little bit long. When you have something a little long, not a problem. Just flip it over and snip. Okay, so that's that. I'm going to set this out of the way. And actually, I think I'll set our card out of the way too. So to stamp the little goats, you're going to need two pieces that are 2.5 inches square and one that is 2.5 by 3 because the one goat is just a little bit taller than the others. And I'm going to use some Tuxedo Black Memento ink, and we'll just go ahead and stamp these guys. Now I got glue on my fingers, everything's sticking to them. Okay, our little dancing goat. And our little fat goat with the sassy eyes. This one is me. It's just me. Then once we have that done, we're going to take some Stampin' Blends. And I used two different colors of the jade green and then the darkest one of the Misty Moonlight. And I did the Misty Moonlight for the center guy. And I will just take the tip that's more like a marker instead of a paintbrush. And I have to take my glasses off. Don't ask me why, but when I do close-up work, I have to take my glasses off. I think of my dad every time I do that. And then what you're going to do is you're going to just run along the outside outlines. Like, you don't want it to go into the goat. But you want to run along the outside, and this is going to give it like a shadowing effect to make your goat stand up out more. And actually, the reason why I did this is one of my friends who comes to my stamp classes, Sandy, does not like to color. I love to color. And my first thought on this card was, oh, we're going to color all the goats in. And then I thought of Sandy. And I thought, oh, let's do something different with the goats to make them stand out. And I decided to do this shadowing technique. Now, I'm not sure if she appreciated it or not, because it is kind of putsy to outline these guys. Fat Goat is going to get the Light Just Jade. Now, the Stampin' Blends do come in a set of light and dark when you purchase them. So for each color, you get a light and a dark marker. They work wonderfully for blending, but they're also great markers just for techniques like this. Then we'll go ahead and do the Tall Dancing Goat with the Dark Just Jade. Of course, you could use any color card base and Stampin' Blends that suited your mood or the need for the card. So now we have all of our goats all colored. You can see it was a little putsy, but not as long a time as it would take you to actually color all of the goats. And it gives your card a little bit different look. So then we're just going to go ahead and adhere them to our card front. And I kind of like to lay them out. I'm not very good at even spacing, so kind of lay them like this. And then we're going to take our stamp and seal. And if you haven't used the stamp and seal yet, give yourself a little time to get used to it. It is a little bit different to use than the old snails. It does tend to sometimes pull the tape off, and then it takes a little while to get it to roll again. I'd have to say that is my only downside to it, but it's really sticky adhesive, which is good, so your cards don't fall apart. So then we're just gonna put our goats on here. I managed to smudge it. Now, I did not put any greetings on this card, sort of on purpose, so that my customers could add whatever they want. And then I just put some extra blocks out when we were doing this card at my card class. So I just wanted to show you, I thought it was really cute what some of my customers did, is they took the weighted goat stamp, and you'd probably want to do this before you adhere it. So we've got the weighted goat. and you can just fit it right in here. And you could use, there's other greetings that you could use that same way. And then for the inside of the card, you're going to cut a piece of Whisper white paper, 3.5 by 8.5. So it works out really easy. You just take the standard Whisper white paper and cut 3.5 inches off of the end of it. And for this, you're going to take the cute little can that our goat likes to eat. I've never really seen a goat eat cans, but it seemed like a, you know, a funny goatish thing. I kind of spin them around, and we can put a few on the top too. It's a long card. Now, I thought this would be a great card, this style, for writing to someone too, because it gives you kind of a nice writing area. And then, now this is kind of crazy, and maybe those of you who are younger than me would get this. My customers seem to get this greeting. Now, it says, "You're the goat, greatest of all time." And I kind of was like, what exactly does that mean? I mean, I guess you're the greatest of all time, but I had never heard that phrase, "You're the goat," before. So we're just going to put that on here, and I'm not coloring anything on here. And then we'll just go ahead and adhere it. So for your friends who enjoy animals or would get the humor of this card, be a great card to make, or you could use this design and put some other elements onto it. So hope you enjoyed learning how to do this simple slimline way to goat card. Have a great day. For a supply list and links to purchase the supplies to make this card, hop on over to my blog. I'll have the link here on the screen at the end.